it is so difficult for me to talk about a subject while doing my makeup and not talk about how I'm doing my makeup. It's just... I feel like I'm explaining it not really well. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I'm going to put some makeup on my face while filming. So yeah, I need to get ready and I thought let's get ready together. So yeah, without any further ado, let's just get into it because I don't have that much time. Let me prime my face, if I can find my brow, here it is. Let's get a little bit of glow on today. So I'm going to start with the... That's actually a very... No intro, no nothing. Oh, it is what it is. I'm going to prime with the Catrice Sensational Primer. It's a very nice, kind of a glowy-ish primer, but not very, very glittery. And I don't know, it does kind of feel abruptly, the beginning, doesn't it? I thought let's play with a palette I haven't played with in quite a while. So the one that I'm going to play with today is actually the Freya palette from Odin's Eye Cosmetics. And this is the color story. Very, very pretty. You can get soft neutral looks, you can get bolder looks, but these two duochromes are so, so pretty. They almost look wet. So let me swatch them for you. They're so pretty. So pretty. This was their first eyeshadow palette. They have another one. They also have a face palette. And I think another eyeshadow palette is on the way. And I'm actually very curious. I didn't get the second palette that they came out with. What's the foundation I want to use today? Yeah, let's just use my Catrice because it's in front of me and I really, really like it. I didn't get the last palette that they came out with because, I don't know, it didn't grab me as much as this one did when they launched it. So that is basically the reason. Let me get a brush as well. So I'm going to do a combination between a brush and sponge today. The foundation I'm going to use today is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage in the color Sand Beige, which is a little bit more my skin tone at the moment. So let's just go to town with it. And it's already December, the year is almost over again. Wow. It's just insane. I don't know why I put it on a brush, because I actually prefer it like this, the back of my hand, and then apply. So yeah, today is the 3rd of December actually. And busy times ahead. My father's birthday is on the 9th. And then, well, obviously we will get Christmas. Then... Then it's one of my niece's birthday, my eldest niece, for the 18th of January. Then my son for the 23rd. And he will be 18 this year, or in 2020. So yeah, there's that. Wow. And then my birthday is February. And then we're kind of set a little bit. So it's usually a little bit of a busy time this time of year. But yeah, it is one of my favorite times of the year. I love Halloween. I love the fall. Only, yeah, you know, a Dutch fall weather is usually wet and stormy. I love snow, but we don't usually get a lot here. Not anymore, which is a shame, because I really love snow. Maybe this year. They've been saying we will get a horror winter for, I don't know, 7 or 8 years or something. Every year I see it floating around on Facebook. This year is going to be a horror winter. Very large piles of snow. Well, not here. I feel like I have hairs everywhere. And it also seems like my foundation is balling up, which is actually really weird because it usually doesn't do that. However, I am using another moisturizer now, so maybe that's it. Now this foundation does oxidize. So if you think, oh Lord, it's too light, it oxidizes, or at least for me it does. Not a lot, but enough that it is not too light for me at the moment. Why is everything boiling up? It's annoying. So apparently, my sunscreen and moisturizer don't really want to talk to each other. So what did I do now? I just sprayed some hydrating toner that I have here, or maybe it's water, I don't know. And then I'm kind of rubbing it in because that helps against pilling. At least for me it does. The only thing is I can't really do that where I have put foundation. Why? I think there was a cat on my towel or something. I have a towel here that I clean my brushes on between colors or between uses. So that I don't have to wash them as often. Because I don't like washing my brushes. I don't really mind washing my powder brushes. My foundation brushes. I hate that. It's one of the reasons I use a sponge a lot of the time. Yeah, that's a bit better, I think. I don't know. Okay. Let's get concealer. If I have a little bit left, because I'm almost out, so I already have a backup of this color. Yeah, if there is something left, I don't have to break it open just yet. So yeah, the end of the year, wow. It went by so quickly. It's just insane, actually. I'm actually going to be 44 next year. Uh-oh. Oh, I forgot to tell you which concealer I'm using, didn't I? I'm using the Catrice One Drop Weightless Coverage. I have been using this for ever since I saw it in store. And it is it almost a year now? I don't know, but it has been a while. Ever since I started using that concealer, there it hasn't been another one. I have tried the e.l.f. Camo concealer. Don't like it. It's too drying, too heavy for my under eye area. This puppy though. This one I bought last winter. Because this is my winter shade. So I have been using it for a year. And this is the shade that I kind of use in summertime. Which is, I think, 030. It has rubbed off. This is 010. And it has now just kind of is running out. It is 7 mils, but you just need a drop. So yeah, it's very, very good concealer. At least in my opinion. It does crease, but then again, everything does. I kind of need to I have been using tretinoin cream. Kind of retin-A. However, I need to get a doctor's prescription for that. And I keep forgetting to call the doctors to get me a new prescription. So yeah, not that I use it underneath my eyes. But it kind of travels up when you apply it. So yeah, I just need to re-get it. And it does really, really help. I did order the retinol from The Ordinary in Squalane. Because I'm actually really curious about that, and then I can kind of use it in between my tretinoin use. My skin should be okay with it because it is okay with a pure vitamin A cream as well. Granted, I always put a layer underneath, and a lot of the time if I use my vitamin A cream, I mix it in with my moisturizer because it is a very thick cream. If I mix it in with my moisturizer, it's easier to spread out. Yeah, I can set the rest of my face with it as well. This is the Revolution Matte Base pressed powder in P2. And now that it is a bit drier, I don't need a lot of powder, but I do want a little bit. And that is why usually in the winter time I tend to prefer pressed powders. Because with loose powders, I tend to overuse. And in summer that's okay, but in winter time, yeah, my skin is just a bit drier. I'm just going to go over it to make sure it's all nice. And I'm just kind of grabbing a little bit of powder to help blend. Now, what I love to do now, my Revolution Pro Skin Finish. I'm so happy that I got this, and it has a dome, but I don't know if you can see it. My dome is getting a little bit flat. I just love this. So I just go with a fluffy brush. Usually not all over my face, but just in certain areas. And if I have... Yesterday, I went with my mother to the hospital to get some test results. And I didn't feel like doing a full face. So I just did foundation. And then a little bit of this. I think I slapped some pink blush on my eyes. And basically that was it. A little bit of blush and highlight on the rest of my face. But this stuff is so pretty. Now you can use it as a highlight as well. Let me show you. Let me get a denser brush for that. Very pretty. And this is the color Opalescent. Oh, this is the one of the reasons that I said in my Would You Rather tag that I did just recently, which I will link, that I would rather give up highlighter. Because this powder, it's not a highlighter, but you can use it as one. So I have here my City Bronzer from Maybelline. I need to see which brush I'm using, this one. So yeah, basically Black Friday has just passed because it is the 3rd, so it's the Tuesday after Cyber Monday. Yeah. Wow. Did you get anything good for Black Friday? Or... did you not? Did you just did not want to get anything for Black Friday? Let me know down below. Usually I have a wish list of stuff that I really want. I didn't get everything because I also really wanted to see about the hourglass powder or the, I don't know, another kind of a high-end powder for my face. I didn't get one. Because, to be quite honest, the powders that I'm using at the moment work for me at the moment. So, yeah, there is that. So, I didn't get any high-end powder. I did get eyeshadow palettes. Let me get my blush palette that I have here from Bella Pierre. And my favorite blush to use is this one, the shade Ballerina. So, I'm going to put that on the face. So, what was on my wishlist for a long, long time was Kaleidos. And I got 3 Kaleidos palettes from my husband because I showed them to him and he was like, ooh, they are pretty. Let me get you 3. So I got the green one and then the neon and the, what is it, teal and orange. I keep forgetting the names. Teal and orange one. I'm going to clean my head as well. And they also just launched their lipsticks, their liquid lipsticks and their glosses. So I got a liquid lipstick I ordered as well. Don't remember which color though. So that's fun. One of the colors. And 5050 Makeup released their winter palette that I also ordered, which has a nice shimmer red in it as well. So I'm good with that, and I hope to receive that palette really quickly so I can kind of use it because I'm really, really excited about it. And I also have been eyeing, more, but I got sent by one of you the Berlin Underground palette from Nomad Cosmetics, and I have been eyeing Nomad Cosmetics for a while. And the quality is so nice of that Nomad palette that when they had their Black Friday sale for their Harakuja palette, I think it is called, their Tokyo palette, I grabbed it on Black Friday for 50% off. So yeah, that one's coming as well. I also ordered some skincare from The Ordinary because I needed new skincare. Yes, do we have everything? And yesterday, as I'm filming this, it was yesterday, I ordered some shades, some things from Crow and Pebble. So yeah, they have something really interesting now. You can kind of create your own shade. I mentioned it in my Let's Talk Makeup that went online yesterday. And yesterday was the 2nd of December. About kind of creating your own shimmer shade. So basically you choose your base shade. That's a matte. And then you choose your shimmer shade. They put it in a jar. And then you have your own customized eyeshadow. So I think that is really, really fun. And brilliant, to be quite honest with you. So I created some kind of duochrome shades. So I have a dark purple base and then a bright green shimmer in one. I have a dark purple base and an orange shimmer in another. I also think I have a gray base and then a yellow shimmer or a golden shimmer. And I kind of made a red. So a reddish base and then a reddish shimmer. Very excited. And they also had kind of a purpley blush, so I ordered that one as well. And it's probably all loose, but I don't mind. Okay, that's good enough. I'm getting my Anastasia Clear Brow Gel that I also received as a gift in the same package as the Nomad palette. And can I just say, oh my lord, I always thought this was very, very hyped up and I didn't need it. This is the brow gel that I have tried, and I have tried a few, that keeps my brows in place, period. So, wind or rain, it keeps them where I put them. My brows are kind of rambunctious. If I want to brush them up, they just want to lay flat. She stinks, but she works so, so well. And I also heard good things about the Essence one. It doesn't do anything for my brows, just saying. So there's that. Okay, this is the base on. I want to bring my shimmer a little bit more down. So I have here my pink eyeball highlighter. I love to use this as a blush topper. I love a glowy blush, and apparently I'm glowy today. I'm just dusting it over with a fluffy brush. Because this is actually a little bit too dark for me as a highlighter, especially now. I just dusted over and now I have a very, very glowy face. Yes. Eyeshadow palette. This is so, so pretty. I'm going to go to this color. I'm going to start with this color, which is called... Damn, this is so small. Trangia, I think, but I'm not really sure because the font on this is bad to read for me. Just saying. Maybe I can kind of show the name. So this is the name. I don't know if it will focus on the name. I'm sorry, but for the life of me, I don't know what it says. But it is a very pretty shade nonetheless, and I'm going to start with it. So let me get my... let me get my Jessup 231. And let's start with that color. I forgot my eyeshadow base again. Wow. Let me get my Catrice. And this is a very nice eyeshadow base as well. I compared this one with the clear one from Smashbox. And this one is better, in my opinion anyway. I do have the Smashbox Lit Primer in Light, and I like that one over this one because that one has a base shade and this one doesn't. So if I have, I don't know, I know I will create a lot of fallout, I will usually grab that one. Or maybe if I have, when I do my eyes first, or maybe if I have staining, I will grab that one as well. But to be quite honest with you, this one is better. Just saying. But yeah. Okay, so I'm going to go back to the color. I'm going to put it in the crease. Blend out the edge a little. And these shades are very, very nice and buttery, nicely pigmented, but not in your face. They are very easy to work with. They are buildable. Very, very pretty. So what kind of holiday plans do you have? Do you have family traditions? Do you, I don't know, go away for the holidays every year? Maybe you don't celebrate the holidays, or maybe you celebrate it differently because you have Christmas, you have Hanukkah, you have Yule. So yeah, you have nothing. What do you celebrate? I'm curious. We are not religious. Well, I kind of am, but not typically, maybe. Let's say I'm pagan. That's basically the easiest way to explain it. I do really, really love the holidays. I have always loved the atmosphere of Christmas, and I don't know, you know, I like it. And we actually celebrate with the whole family on Christmas Eve. On Christmas Eve, everyone gathers around here, and I'm going to blend. And we have snacks. You know, it's everyone brings something to eat. We have snacks. We have presents for the children usually, and sometimes usually we kind of draw numbers. I don't know how to explain it. Names, and then, you know, you get a present for one person. That's basically it. I don't really know how to explain it in English. So that's with our family. I want it a little bit higher there. I also want it a bit darker, so I'm going to build it up in the crease. And we kind of did, or we kind of started that tradition because, you know, you get your family, you are maybe married, and then you have to go to your relatives, you know. So we were like, you know what, let's do it for the family, our family, on Christmas Eve, so that for the rest of the holiday, everyone can do what they want to do. So it has been a tradition for, I think, 19 years or something like that. And yeah, I think it's a lot of fun. But what I also celebrate with my pagan circle friends stuff is the Yule celebration. And basically the Yule celebration, the way we celebrate it, we celebrate the returning of the light on the winter solstice, or at least as close as we can get it, because a lot of people work. And so yeah, we usually pick the first Saturday closest to the actual winter solstice. That was, wow, it's difficult to talk today. It is so difficult for me to talk about a subject while doing my makeup and not talk about how I'm doing my makeup. It's just, I need to practice. It's very difficult. But yeah, and this year, if I'm not mistaken, it is actually on the 21st, so on the winter solstice. But yeah, so, and what do we do then? We basically make a present. We have to make the present ourselves. We cannot buy anything, you know. I'm going to go into the color Agoon, I think it is, this one. With my Luxe Pencil, the 230 from Jessup. And yeah, so yeah, we make a present. We don't know for who, we just make a present. Then we put it in a big white envelope, and we put a number on it. And then when we are ready to kind of draw, ready for the presents, we draw a number, and that number corresponds with an envelope, and then that's our present. So everyone makes something. And the funny thing is that the presents all go there where they are needed. It is just amazing. And we have been doing that for a few years as well, and it's really fun. Usually we also, usually when we celebrate that kind of thing. It is evenings only, except for the Yule celebration, because the Yule celebration is basically all day. Last year, I think it was last year, we went to the, or was it the year before? No, the year before, we went to the forest during the day with our group, and then, you know, we left some presents for basically nature in the forest. Or in the woods, it's a very tiny woods, but still we have them. And then we went and ate together. And that is usually how we do it. So basically we are busy with it all day. I feel like I'm explaining it not really well. But yeah, there is that. I'm going to go to the color Valletta, which is this one. I thought it was going to be a simple two-tone look, but apparently I was mistaken. So, and then that's basically our holiday done. I don't know how interesting that was, but that's how we kind of celebrated. Oh, I forgot to say, I'm dipping back into the first color that I cannot pronounce to help define my eye a little bit better. Now it's shimmer time. I kind of need to think which one I want to use, because the shimmers in here are all very, very pretty.
1 minute, 37 seconds later.
Yes, I wanted that one underneath my eye, didn't I? The color Yule. So let me do that. So I want to start with the color Yule, which is this one. And it is so, so pretty. I want that underneath my eye. I, however, need to spray it. Because everything I put underneath my eye, I spray. I'm also kind of working it into the crease a little bit. The funny thing is that every time I kind of open up this palette, these are basically the shades that I end up using, excuse me, because I love them so, so much. But yeah. For the lid, so I have here the NYX Glitter Primer and the 233, what is it, cream shadow shader, whatever brush from the Jessup set, which is a very, very nice brush. I have first impression slash demo on my channel. I will link it. It should be online. And this brush really, really surprised me, because it's very, very good, or at least in my opinion, it's very good. I'm first going to go to the color Sin Sin. And these are kind of wet looking shades, or at least that's how I feel about them. They do have a base shade, but they sometimes appear a bit sheer. But look how pretty. Oh! Let me get a little bit of this one, which is called Gracia. Gracia, whatever. And this brush has a nice tip to it, so I can get into my inner corner. And this one is more of a topper shade, so it doesn't really have a base. But it is nice and kind of sparkly. This brush where I use the color Yule, just a tiny bit of Yule, and I'm just going to flick it in and blend it a little bit. I want to layer a little bit of that second shimmer on top. It was not what I was going to do today. I was going to do a softer look today. Honestly, this is the prettiest brown-green duochrome that I have in my collection by far. I have nothing like it. I'm going to grab that face highlighter part thingy. I'm going to try and clean off my pencil brush a bit. I really, really like this pencil brush, by the way, because it is, for me, perfect for my inner corner, because it's not too flimsy. It's a little bit more stiff, but not too stiff. It's perfect. Why do I have a sparkle on my nose? I don't know if you can see it, but I can see it in the mirror. I have a sparkle there on the tip of my nose. One. Wow. I'm grabbing a little bit of rune because that one also has a bit of green sparkle in it. It's just a different green and the base shade is a bit different. So yeah. Okay. Yes, that is it for the eye look. I can put an eye pencil on. I don't think I really need it, but let's go there. Anyway, I have here the Essence Electric Vibes in hashtag no regrets. It's a really nice eye pencil. Glides on like a dream. Stays on all day. I was not going to do a red look. I'm very sorry. Well, actually I'm not. You are probably going to see a lot of reddish looks on my channel this time of year. Or at least this month. I'm just warning you now. Where is my... Here. I'm going to tight line and no one wants to see that. I just have a generic black gel liner pencil. This one is from number 7. Doesn't matter which one you have. I'm going to tight line there and then I will be back. I also dotted it. Dotted it. Oh, weird, weird. A little bit here that I'm going to smudge. Yes. Okay. Eyeliner. I cannot talk while I'm doing this, so I will probably speed it up or I will even cut it out depending on how long the video is. So yeah, there's that. Just so you know. Okay. Let me get my mascara. Let's use the Glam & Doll Waterproof. I'm going to grab my falsies that are still downstairs. I'm also going to choose a lippy and then I will be back and show you the finished look. Yeah, that's basically it. I'm going to do that. Yes, now. Wow. Everything is on and here is the finished look. So I completed the entire ensemble, including sweater, scarf, earrings and all that goodness. You saw me before the falsies, right? Where my eyeliner was not as big as this, right? What I usually do when I have put on my falsies, I go over it with my eyeliner just on the edge to hide any glue that may be showing, to kind of tie everything in. However, today, apparently, this happened. So yeah, wasn't supposed to be that thick, but it is what it is. But yeah. I'm not... For lip combination, I use the Catrice Lip Foundation in the color I Take You to the Chocolate Shop. And then for lipstick is the Catrice Generation Matte Comfortable Liquid Lipstick in the color Muddy Madness. And it kind of offsets a little bit the things that I have going on there. The falsies are my more natural ones from Sosu that I get at Primark. The earrings are actually made by Raven's Ear on Instagram. However, these are unique. So, yeah, go check out her Instagram. But you cannot get these because these were specifically made for me. Just so you know. But yeah, this was it. This was my... I don't know, getting ready for work and let me slap some makeup on my face. I will leave the makeup that I used down in the description box. I'm very happy that I got to play with this one again because it is such a great palette. It is so, so pretty. And the quality is amazing. So I will leave the site from Odense Eye Cosmetics down below. They are kind of expanding now. As I said, they have now, I think, 2 eyeshadow palettes, a face palette. They also have lippies now. So yeah, go check them out. They are based in Sweden. They're a European indie brand. So yeah, there is that. I think that is it. I'm going to stop talking. I'm going to go to work. And look fabulous the rest of the day. Yeah. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I will see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.